It has two cubes in here and a cylinder and a para and a couples of torus in there. Let's create that. Let's create a cube. Bring it up here and scale it down. Scale a little bit bigger. Scale in Y and place it in here. And for this we don't need to create a one more face in there, so we can select this face and scale it down. And the face selected and extrude it again and move with the blue axis up. Now we have not created a new cube in that. And now let's create this cylinder. Bring it up. Bring it here. Let's go to the front view and place it and scale as much as we need. In here, it's up to this wall, so we have to scale a little bit more. And we don't need any caps in there, so make the caps to 0. And the default of 20 segments is so smooth, it's enough. And delete the bottom and the top faces in there. Deselect these faces and delete. Now we have deleted the caps now. Now we have to create this pair. Go to the front view and reduce its segments to 12. We can smooth it later, or we may use the NURBS sphere in there. Place it as it fits in the center. Go to the side view and place it as it fits in the side view. And let's create a torus and bring it up here. We may reduce its size to 8, so we can smooth it later. Scale this torus. It's in the center of the sphere there. Reduce its section radius and bring it up here and scale. Reduce its segments to 2. Subdivision axis to 20. 24. It's smooth now. Subdivision axis height is enough. We don't need to smooth it here. Smooth this mesh. Go to the top view and fit it to the center of this sphere. Make it collide like this. And this shape, for this shape, we can duplicate this from here. Scale it down. Put it in there. It's perfect now. Let's make these pair segments to 20, so we do not need to smooth it. And with the torus also, let's add 4 segments to it. We don't need to smooth it anymore. This is enough for now. And for this torus, we have to duplicate this and put it in there. Second one is a little bit larger, so scale it up a little bit and make one in the bottom. Duplicate and bring it down here and scale it down a little bit. It's finished for now. Let's save the file. Now we have to parent all these to one object, so it's easy to select. Select sphere, torus and this cylinder, and lastly select this cube steps in there. So press P to parent it. If you select now the bottom part, it will select the whole mesh, so we can duplicate easily and move it in here. Save it again. This front part is finished now. Let's move on to the top part. First we have to create this cube in here. Let's do that. Before that, there is a floor kind of thing in here. We have to make that now. Create a cube. Move it up here. Scale it in the sideways. And in the width, scale it down in Y. Scale a little bit bigger. So it will come out of this pillar. It's looking good. Let's add some definition in there. In the height, let's add one segment. Let's select this loop and scale a little bit and bevel. Increase its segments to 2, so it will look very smooth now. It's perfect. Let's save it again. Now let's create this cube. Now create polygon primitives cube. For this, let's turn on the template. Now it's getting a little bit higher now. The template is only just a approximate size, not a perfect one. It's good now. Let's copy this part from the front part in here. For that, we are going to parent all these things. Select the hemisphere lastly and press P to parent. And now let's duplicate it and bring it up here. I knew that our castle is not a square one, but this cube is a square. So let's scale this cube a little bit wider in this manner. And scale this thing to 2. Maybe we can scale it, this cube a little bit bigger one. Move this a little bit outer, but it may cross the wall. Let's duplicate this, bring it up here and rotate its Y to 0, 180, 270. And keep it up here. And also in this side base also we have to make a duplicate of it. So duplicate, bring it up here, rotate its Y to 0, move it to center, go to the top view, move it up here. And let's see, it's not crossing the wall, So move it a little bit. Press Ctrl D. Duplicate it again. To 180. Rotate it and fix it in here. Now we have all the four duplicates in there. Save the file. And now let's duplicate this thing. But in here it needs to be very bigger. So scale it as we need. Bring it down. Duplicate this. Bring it up here. Select these two and duplicate and move it up here. Save the file. And now let's create this part. This part. For that, we have to use the hemisphere completely. We don't have to cut it up. So we may take it from this piece, and duplicate it. For this cylinder, we have to create it a new one. Create polygon primitives, cylinder. As we did before, it needs the segments to be 8, but we don't have to cut it now. And make it the size of the remaining pieces. Bring it down. It seems equal now. And now in this cylinder we don't need any caps. Set the caps to 0 and select this face and extrude it. Up, move it up and scale it up, extrude again and move it up, extrude again, move it up and scale. And add one edge loop in here and scale it up. To make it smoother, we don't have to smooth it now. And we have to make these window panes appear in there. For that, I'm going to duplicate. In here we have no duplicates in there, so we have to create this duplicate. Rotate its Y to 0 and fix it there. I wonder why it's missing. Let's select this sorry for this. I have forgot to make this, duplicate this and move it up here. Duplicate one more and move it up here. Let's deal this cylinder here. Duplicate one window pane here and go to the top view. Just rotate it and fix it with one side. Press D to edit its pivot and bring it up here. For this purpose, we need to create a we can delete these edges afterwards. We just created to make this pivot to get exactly to the center here. And let's duplicate and rotate in here. Let's clear its transformations, freeze transform, and let's duplicate it and move it up here. It's 45 degrees exactly. So we have noted that how many copies we need. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 we have that. We need to create 7 copies. Go to edit, duplicate special, make it a copy, and in the rotate, let's reset it, and in the rotate by 45 degrees, and number of copies to be 7, and duplicate special. It's done. Now we can delete these. These edges and click delete edge and vertex. Let's see how it looks here. It's not fixed inside. You have to make it move a little bit more inside before that. Let's undo. Let's remove it. Go to the cap view. We have to fix in this in here and change its pivot again to the center. And now the duplicate special settings will be retained, so we don't have to go to its option. Let's click duplicate special. It's complete now. And for the hemisphere, we'll duplicate this. And move it here. Select this thing and select it. Select this again. And press P to parent it. So if we scale, it will scale it evenly.